Hi Leo, here is a general look at your solar chart for October 2015. And just a mention of the new moon this month, which can be quite interesting, is that the new moon is happening in Libra, and that's on October the 13th, in a good aspect with your sign, and is opposing Uranus in Aries. So your longer term transit of Uranus in Aries, which started in 2011, is meaning that this is a time in your life to be experimental with your thinking, to keep your mind open to different ways of being, different cultures, the way others are, learning a lot from that, but maybe another field of learning, another field of knowledge through going into higher education. This would be a great thing for you to be doing. And this transit goes on till 2019. And so over this longer term, dawning within you is this new way of looking at things. You'll realize that your picture of yourself, let alone an ideology or belief or a field of knowledge, is incomplete. And you will, sometimes through challenge, go forwards into something which is more freeing, more exciting, more inspiring. You gradually discover what's missing. Then you come into this time of maybe through a series of little revelations, come into this more interesting time. And this is a great time to study something unconventional as well, like astrology perhaps, or UFOs, and to allow your mind to open through travel and through interacting with others who have a very different take on things to yourself. This is also a great time for you to seek teaching. Look for that teacher that you really need. It might be a human being, but it might not. It might be a place, you know, or it might be another kind of being. So that's a sort of general look at Uranus. Now, the new moon, which is happening on the 13th, means that you can improve the way you communicate, source, or use the media. Or you can just improve the communication equipment or communication, anything to do with communications, anything to do with improving things through use of people skills, maybe. You know, having to deal with tricky people or situations, having those good people skills, or that ability to persuade, negotiate, all of that through this new moon time connecting to Uranus for the 4 weeks from the 13th. This means that this is a time you can make those new connections, write that. I think 4 weeks is probably too short a time to write a book, but you can sketch things out if it's like that, or study the new subject, or indeed get together the paperwork that you need to in order to steer you in the direction you want to be going in, and not in the direction that maybe others are forcing you into. Just getting together the having the conversations, making the contacts, getting together the things that you need for your life to sail forwards in the direction that you want it to be, in this time, this overall time of you keeping your mind open to seeing the world and maybe your place in it differently. Now, other news is that until the 24th, the sun is in this area, this very sociable, busy communications area. It could be meeting and greeting, connecting with others, correspondence, paperwork, sharing what you know, sourcing useful information, that kind of thing, maybe running around more, maybe just in your head, maybe not. And Mercury's also there. It's quite a chatty area. It's increasing interchanges. You've got to keep, you know, your eye on the ball, as it were. and possibly you learning stuff, but also you having to be in these interactions with others, whether you like it or not. And Mercury is retrograde though until the 9th. So Mercury was retrograde for a lot of the previous month. So Mercury is retrograde until the 9th, and that means there can be slowdowns. You know, you don't get the answer back, or somebody gets the wrong end of the stick, or it, you know, and all of that stuff, rescheduling things, maybe it gives you a chance to think it through better. It might be a blessing in disguise, actually. Cross the I's, dot the T's, that kind of thing. Venus has been in your sign for quite some time, and went in there on June the 6th. And this has been really good news for you. Using the energy in the smartest way that you possibly can would have been a good idea. Giving a more sharing mood, you being there for somebody else, maybe you being more gregarious, maybe you in a teamwork sort of scenario, that the sharing is a big key word for Venus, and compromising, maybe cooperating, but meeting the world with more ease and enthusiasm, and sort of ideas maybe, or feelings indeed, because this could boost your love life flowing between you. Now, depending on when you're listening to this, Venus is coming out of there on the 9th and goes into back into her normal cycle, which is about 3 weeks per sign. So this has been an exceptionally long transit of this planet of harmony, ease, flow, and also maybe even, you know, goodies in the pipeline coming your way as well. Financially, possibly, particularly at the time that Venus is connecting to one of your to your sun, or maybe to another of your planets in your natal chart. So Venus moves relatively quickly, so you have to, you know, reach for the opportunities as they come along. And people would tend to like your style with Venus in your sign. It's a good time to have a bit of a makeover, I have to say. You know, go out and maybe you even get fed up with it in the end because Venus is there for so long. But look at what you can do to kind of get scrubbed up a bit, you know, and maybe get a new look, that kind of thing. Or maybe it's not about that. Maybe it's about your love life or your friendships, you know, because these are all Venus things. Professional relationships tend to get a boost as well. And you mix and mingle successfully or connect with those important to you. It could be, you know, an opportunity. Somebody just takes a liking to what you've got to contribute in some way, or do they just like you? I mean, let's face it, you know, you're lovable and cuddly, aren't you? You're a pussycat. And that could be good news for you. On the other hand, you could, as I say, be quite self-indulgent. So putting your hand in your pocket a little bit more as well, or maybe bending over backwards for another a little bit more because you are such a push the cat. But this is a good time overall to work the energy to your advantage. Now then, having said all that, Venus coming out of there on the 9th of October and going into an area concerning income, money, finance, property, possessions, resources of various kinds, and how you can really maximize the potential there. So that looks quite interesting as well, because you also are going to be having Mars and Jupiter in that area. So again, there's going to be a lot of emphasis on this area. Even though Venus is only in there for about 3 weeks, Mars is going to be in there a little bit longer, and Jupiter's going to be there until next September. And, you know, if I was to line up all the planets and say, which planet would I like to be in a long-term long-term transit of my money area, it would be, because I know Jupiter does long-term transits, it would be Jupiter. But if I could get a long-term one out of Venus, I'd choose Venus over Jupiter, probably. However, having said that, it depends on the natal chart anyway. But in general, Jupiter in your area of the piggy bank, property and possessions, is no bad thing. So it now, Jupiter is a planet of learning through doing. So you're going to be on a learning curve about, you know, how you really want it to be and how you want things to be running and what you don't want over this nearly 12 months now that Jupiter's going to be in there. But Venus coming in there for these 3 weeks, that's you know, it can be a good thing. And it can mean that buying, selling, renting, leasing, or any other sort of money-related kind of decisions or moves tend to kind of go in your favor. Or it might not be money, it might be the resource for money, or the setup, or the contract, or maybe it is that you and somebody are collaborating better, and you're getting your act together, which means that will help you with your personal finances. Or it might not be like that at all. Maybe you and someone are really, really appreciating all of this oodles and oodles of cash that you're sort of swimming around in. But who knows? It could be like that as well. This feeling of comradeship or brotherhood, sisterhood, or friendship, or and just really enjoying and appreciating the resource that you've got coming around you, and that will be from the 9th for a relatively short period of time. However, Mars in there is longer, and Mars has you making the decisions, and maybe taking the actions, you know, that you need to improve things where your material security is concerned. The piggy bank, possessions, territory, whether that's intellectual territory or actual stuff, or indeed it is, again, you know, around property. You could be striving to get your hands on certain things, or places, but watch your step related to the basic material side of life. You could be shoving things around, storing things, ditching things, and just all of that basic stuff. You're going to have to be quite physically active around and making decisions as you go forwards, and that includes actual money. And you could be more actively engaged in diet and health matters, your own or somebody else's. So if there are decisions to be made, and you know, you want to up your game, you want to get more organized, then this Mars transit through there in October is going to mean that you're getting busy there. Mars can be quite feisty though. So there might be somebody that is being a bit pushy about that area of life, or it might be you're being a bit pushy about that area of life. I mean, it might be both. However, this is not just about materiality. This is also about your own abilities, your own inner inborn assets, and everybody has them. And so it might mean, and this is the one I would tend to go for personally, that this transit, which is being emphasized by Jupiter over the longer term as well, of Mars going through there short term, is to take your own gifts and talents more seriously and see how you can apply those in a more dynamic way to really get that reward, that material reward, if it is like that for you, that you want to have, that you need, so that everything's covered. So that's another way of looking at that. The sun moves on the 24th and means your attention could center more around your base of operations. You're busier at home, or you're busier on a base of operations, wherever you are, if you're not at home. Or to do with the family, or to do with a community, whether it's in your locality or online, your tribe, and also property matters may have your attention more, and home improvements, maybe that kind of thing. But this is an area where you might feel a little bit more sensitive, you might be more introspective and pondering things, but you do certainly need to listen to your intuition, your instincts, with the sun in there. Saturn has returned to Sagittarius. So that happened on September the 17th, and she will stay there until the end of 2017. This puts her in a positive angle with your sun sign, Leo. Whereas previously, for the previous 2.5 years, she's been at quite a sort of contentious, challenging, working angle to your sun sign. Now she comes into a more positive, helpful angle to your sun sign. So that's good news. And over this next couple of years, it can mean ultimate success if you pay more focused, nurturing attention to your creativity, or your more playful side, your freer side, the activities which are maybe not the day job, maybe they're hobbies, maybe they're pastimes, maybe they're leisure pursuits, maybe they're not anything about that, maybe they're to do with children, young people. But because it's Saturn, always, wherever Saturn goes, we have to bite the bullet sometimes. We have to take the long view. We have to get organized so that we can build this new structure according to the area that Saturn is in. So it might be that you've got a creative work on the table, or and you have been procrastinating about it, or maybe you haven't even started at all. So this would be a good time to get your skates on with that one, although you don't want to be going too fast, because again, wherever Saturn is, we have to learn to do it bit by bit, a bit at a time. Or maybe it's some other project or enterprise that you need to put steady, persevering work into, not necessarily just work, but steady, persevering effort into, which gives you a reward, which makes you feel empowered because you've really got a hold of it and it's yours, you see. So you just need to be more self-disciplined. You need to be patient. You also don't need to be dictatorial, which is a fault with Leo, I have found. Even though it might be meant well, it's a question of, okay, seeing what you've really got to work with and play with, and then get on and play and have fun out of it. And this is an extremely creative, entrepreneurial area that Saturn is going to be in. And so you've got to be patient, you've got to be persevering. You might more than once feel snagged or blocked or held up or held back, because Saturn is Saturn. She's there to help us to really learn our craft or learn our limitations. She's about limitations, so it's to learn our limitations within the parameters of what we're doing, and then to say, okay, I got all this space, I don't need any more. And then really concentrate. She's like lasering down to a real, real strong point, and then getting on in a creative, enterprising way within that, okay, and not getting distracted off in various other areas, whatever it's about for you. Or it might be about a young person. It might be about that, and you just got to give that more time and attention and patience. And then you're on the road to building a solid and robust structure which stands the test of time. And it will always stand the test of time in the future. You, Leo is born the 23rd to the 28th of July with 0 to 5 degrees rising. Or you, Leo, is born on the 22nd of August and 29th degrees rising. Going to feel that energy the most. Jupiter is in your area of the piggy bank. That's good. Just under a year, and so you must remain open to whatever resources, knowledge, assets, talents, you know, outer assets around you, but inner assets as well. You might help you to expand mentally or physically into fresh territories, which can then, you know, net in the financial rewards that you need. Such decisions could teach you a great deal and turn out to be lucrative or worthwhile in other ways down the line. And Jupiter here will also help you to prioritize, help you decide, okay, you know, what order of play do I have to do all this in, and to think positively about basic resources. It will generally mean that you're likely to improve things in that material sense over that year. You, Leo, is born the 3rd to the 9th of August, or with 11 to 17 degrees rising. Going to feel that the most this forecast period. And just time to say, I'm very sorry if you didn't get your emails answered. We've just discovered a broken link on the website. This is August I'm talking to you. So I hope it will all be sorted out by the time you listen to this. This is all written up on my website, dianagarland.com. And if you know your moon sign, listen to that, or your rising sign, listen to that. And I will see you the next time.